go. It's only about a couple hours drive from where we live, and we've been here before. We came to the museum 3 years ago. This year, in honor of Mickey's 90th, they have a special exhibit, Mickey Mouse from Walt to the World. So we're gonna go check it out again, and we're gonna enjoy this exhibit and enjoy our time in San Francisco. We are driving into the city, and we're actually going to be driving over the Golden Gate Bridge. If you're here visiting, you can actually walk across the bridge. You can see people walking, or you can actually bike.
Rent bikes, and if you bike.
Yeah, people rent bikes. Here are some right here. If you're visiting, you can obviously fly into the city, and into the San Francisco airport. Or if you're in California, you can take a bridge, the Bay Bridge, or this Golden Gate Bridge into San Francisco. You can take a ferry, or you can also take the Bay Area Rapid Transit train into the city. The museum is located in an area called Presidio, and it's just a really pretty area. And there is the museum. So now we'll just grab parking. They have limited options in front of the museum. Well, there it is. Are you about to score an awesome spot?
Yep.
Good job, Uber driver.
Thank you.
All right, here we are.
We made it.
We made it. Walt Disney Family Museum.
I'm excited.
Check it out.
We got our ticket.
All right, we got them. Look at that. So they're going to have us start off at the Mickey exhibit first. And then from there, we'll go to the general admission museum area.
Follow the Mickey.
Shows you where we're going.
The museum staff is coming around and giving some fun facts, and the artist that did these three pieces is actually colorblind. This might be one of my favorites so far. It's Mickey all throughout the city of San Francisco. So here he is on the Golden Gate Bridge. There's the little Pixar.
It's the Bay Bridge, where you have Pixar.
Pixar Studio, the trolley. Oh, I hid Mickey in the trees. Mm-hmm. I really like this one.
Mm-hmm, it's good.
This piece is by Andy Warhol. The sparkles are actually diamond dust. That is amazing. We loved the Mickey exhibit.
It's really good.
I know. So now we're going to go back to the main museum. So for general admission for adults, it's $25 a person. And then if you wanted to add on the special exhibit, it was just an extra $10 per person. The museum was opened by Walt's daughter, Dianne, and starts off with all of his awards and accolades. There's an Academy Award right here. It's just amazing to see in person. Here are the original furnishings that Walt had in his apartment over the firehouse in Disneyland.
So the museum was started by Walt's daughter, Dianne, and she dedicated it to her dad.
And everything here in the museum is...
is related to the family and about the family.
And about Walt Disney. Yeah. Here's Walt with his first camera. It says it cost him $300, which I can imagine would be a lot back then.
1922, and yeah.
Here it is. The elevator looks like we're in a train.
California Limited. Let's see. Free and happy, you know. 1923,
but
I failed. I think it's important to have
a good time. Failure. Walt arrived to Hollywood in 1923 with $40 in his pocket. And that is where he created the Alice comedies. Walt created Oswald, the Lucky Rabbit, in 1927. He lost the rights to him in 1928. And then also in 1928 was the birth of Mickey Mouse. The earliest known drawing of Mickey Mouse.
In those days, you couldn't do what we call dubbing today, when you could mix a lot of tracks. We wasn't yet to the science, but we had a way of doing it. So we had a little kind of a little.
This is all of the Mickey Mouse merchandise of the 1930s.
There were all musicians working for me, so they could follow those beats. And when it came to a certain number of beats, they would go pop, or they would go bang, or they would go this, or they would pop one of these pop guns, you know?
Snow White was the first full-length animated film. A lot of people told Walt that it would not be successful, and of course it was wildly successful. And after the success of Snow White came Bambi and Pinocchio. And of course, many more after that. Here is my favorite, Cinderella. This bracelet that Walt is holding, that Lillian is wearing on her wrist, is right here. There's the Golden Gate Bridge. And now we're going to be learning about Disneyland. And it all started with this bench. This bench is from Griffith Park, where Walt got the idea for Disneyland. The Lily Bell.
Isn't that cool?
Why did you just say that this was your favorite part of the museum?
So I like looking at the little models of the park. So down there you can see that they'll have little replicas of the parks when it was first designed. It's really cool to see the original designs.
The Disneyland proposal.
All right, so here's the model of Disneyland.
This is so cool.
Really cool.
Look at this.
Got the Carousel of Progress right there.
Space Mountain.
Space Mountain.
What do you think?
Very cool, huh?
Look at Fantasyland. You can see the teacups.
So you can see the...
And Dumbo.
And then down here you have It's a Small World.
Right down the middle of Main Street, USA. The old vintage posters. There's Walt Disney. It all started with a mouse. Here are the booklet of tickets that you would buy for Disneyland, and then you would basically pay per ride, so you could get so many little tickets.
Actually, it wasn't as simple as that. Just as we had to learn to make our animated cartoons talk, we had to find a way to make these characters talk too. Now, to accomplish this, we created a new type of animation. So new that we had to invent a new name for it.
Audio animatronics?
Right, audio animatronics.
In the tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki room, in the tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki-tiki room, hardly birds sing words and the flowers croon, thanks to audio animatronics in the tiki room.
This is the model of Carousel of Progress that first appeared at the World Fair and is now in Tomorrowland at Walt Disney World. Look at those three. We just exited the actual art gallery, and then they have a little cafe with some seating over that way, and then over here they have the museum store, which we're gonna go check out right now. It's pretty cool in here. They have bags and t-shirts, postcards, books, pins. It's cool. It's cute. This is a multi-plane camera.
It's the bottom, and there's like a bird painting right up here. And then there's another one right up here.
Oh my gosh, that is so crazy. It's huge. We just finished our tour of the museum. It was
great.
It was amazing.
Oh yeah, it was fun.
If you love Disney, if you love Walt Disney, we would absolutely recommend it.
Yeah.
It's just fascinating to learn about and learn about Walt and how he, you know, his life and how he created Mickey Mouse and Disneyland and the Florida Project and Epcot and everything he did in his life and what an entrepreneur he was. It's just really fascinating.
Yeah, it was really cool. It took you through a timeline as you started it, through when he started his ideas of Mickey Mouse all the way through his creation of the park. So it was pretty cool. And yeah. We would recommend it. It was a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
Really cool area.
Now we're gonna go finish our afternoon in San Francisco. We are walking down to the beach. There's the Golden Gate Bridge.